On behalf of the Texas Department of State Health Services Newborn Screening Team, thank you for the work that you do every day to ensure that every baby in Texas receives the best medical services possible to ensure a healthy life. This short video will guide you through the process for preparing and shipping newborn screening specimens to the Newborn Screening Laboratory. Timely submission of the newborn screening Bloodspot card is as important as completing the card correctly and obtaining a good quality specimen. Thank you for taking time out of your busy day. Let's get started. Once a specimen is collected, allow it to dry for 3 to 4 hours. Dry specimens in one central location so they aren't forgotten or misplaced. Don't put wet specimens in a sealed bag or container to transfer them to the drying location. Lay specimens flat to dry on a non-absorbent surface or in a specially designed drying rack. Specimens should never be stacked or mailed when wet. Do not expose specimen cards to heat, moisture, or direct sunlight, as this may cause the test results to be inaccurate or the specimen to be unsatisfactory for testing. When the specimen is dry, review the specimen demographic sheet for completeness, accuracy, and legibility. Each submitting facility should develop and implement a process to document and track specimens sent to the DSHS laboratory each day. This information can help to troubleshoot result reports that have not been received in the expected time frame. In addition, a tracking process will help facilities accredited by the College of American Pathologists meet specimen tracking requirements. After specimens have dried and the documentation has been completed and checked, package the specimen for shipment and complete any shipping documentation. Dried specimens require two levels of containment for shipping. The first level of containment is the attached fold-over flap that covers the dried blood spots. To avoid compromising the specimen, do not tape down or seal the flap to the specimen. The second level of containment is the envelope provided by DSHS for mailing or the courier shipping envelope. Do not ship specimens to DSHS and a sealed airtight envelope such as a FedEx clinical pack. These packs can be easily identified by their thick orange border. The FedEx large pack is an acceptable envelope for shipping. National recommendations state that first screened specimens should arrive at the testing laboratory within 24 hours after collection. If a specimen is collected today, it should arrive at the DSHS laboratory by tomorrow. Facilities that are successful in achieving this recommendation generally schedule the blood draw in the early morning hours to allow the specimen sufficient time to dry, all documentation to be completed, and to ship the specimen out the same day. There are situations that may prohibit submitters from meeting the 24-hour recommendation, such as specimens drawn before weekends or holidays. Send the specimens to DSHS as soon as possible, preferably by overnight courier. Collect the specimen to allow 3 to 4 hours for drying time and to be shipped out the same day. Communicate to outpatient labs, nurseries, drawing stations, and neonatal intensive care units the daily cutoff time for specimens to be delivered to their packaging area. Assign a staff and backup person to be responsible for tracking the status of each collection and shipment. Develop a procedure for documenting which specimens are sent with each shipment or package. Ship dried specimens directly from the collection facility to the DSHS laboratory. Using an intermediary facility for processing prior to shipping the specimen to DSHS will cause delays. Never hold specimens for bulk mailing. Monitor performance and identify delays in the process. Identify possible process improvements at your facility to minimize transit time. Submitters can monitor their 24-hour submission rate by accessing the newborn screening report card. The report card identifies strengths and opportunities for improvement. In addition, the report card will allow you to compare your facility's performance to the state average. When special situations arise, or if you have questions, contact the DSHS Newborn Screening Lab for assistance whenever needed.